Hello everyone, I welcome you all for the course Engineering Metrology. So this is the third lecture on the topic of acceptance tests for the machine tools. So the contents of the today's topic are recalling of the lecture 2, and then we'll discuss the alignment tests on a pillar type or drilling machine, and then we'll discuss the alignment tests on radial drilling machine, and then we'll discuss the alignment tests on a surface grinding machine. And then we'll discuss the practical tests. Then I will summarize the today's topic contents. So in the lecture 2, we understood how to conduct the alignment test on milling machine. So in that, we understood how to conduct the flatness test on the work table and the parallelism of the work table surface to main spindle, and the parallelism of the clamping surface of the work table in its longitudinal direction, and then the parallelism of the transverse moment of the work table to the main spindle, both in the horizontal plane and the vertical plane, and the true running of the internal taper of the spindle, center T-slot of work table with the main spindle, parallelism of the T-slot with the longitudinal moment of the table, and the parallelism between the main spindle and the guiding surface of the overhanging arm, and the alignment test on the shaping machine we have seen. And in that, we understood how to conduct the straightness and the flatness of the table, and the parallelism of a top surface to a table to its transverse moments, and the parallelism of a table top to ram moment, trueness and parallelism of vertical base of the column, the accuracy, squareness and parallelism of T slots on the table, and alignment test for the slotting machine. So in that, we understood how to conduct the various tests: flatness of work table, squareness of ram slide with the table, squareness of the saddle with the ram, squareness of cross slide with the ram, accuracy, squareness and parallelism of the T slots on the table. Coming to the today's class, alignment test on pillar type drilling machine. So in this first test is flatness of clamping surface of the base. So for conducting this, we require a straight edge and two gauge blocks and feeler gauges. So this is the base of the pillar type drilling machine. On the base, we place the two gauge blocks. On the two gauge blocks, we place a straight edge. And then we use the feeler gauges to check the gap between the straight edge and the gauge blocks. So here the straight edge is placed on the two gauge blocks on the base plate at different positions, and the error is noted down by inserting the filler gauges. And the maximum permissible error is 0.1 mm per 1000 mm clamping surface, and the surface should be concave only. Second test is the flatness of a clamping surface of the plate. So in this, the test is performed same as in the first test, but we place the straight edge and the gauge blocks on the table instead of base plate, and the permissible error is also same. Another test is perpendicularity of a drill guide to the table base plate. So the instrument required for conducting this test is frame level. So the squareness, that is perpendicularity of the drill head guide to the table, is tested. So that is in a vertical plane passing through the axis of both the spindle and the column, and in plane at 90 degrees to the plane at A. So this is the pillar type drilling machine. So these are the frame levels. So the test is performed by placing the frame level So which has the graduations from 0.03 to 0.05 mm on a guide column under the table. And the error is noted by noting the difference between the readings of the two frame levels. And the maximum permissible error is 0.25 mm for 1000 mm guide column for A. And the guide column should be inclined at the upper end towards the front. And 0.15 mm for 1000 mm for B. For testing the perpendicularity of a drill guide to the base plate, so the test is similar to the above, but only the difference is being the that the frame level is to be placed on the base instead of the table. So this frame level is placed on the base plate instead of the table. Another test is a perpendicularity of the spindle sleeve with the base plate. So this test is performed in both the planes as specified in test 3. And procedure is also similar. The only difference is that the frame levels are to be placed on the spindle sleeve under the base plate. And the maximum permissible error is 0.25 mm in plane A and 0.15 mm in the plane B. And a true running of the spindle taper, the test, we require a test manual for conducting this, and we require a dial gauge. So how to conduct the true running of the spindle taper? So here the test manual is fitted in the main spindle. So main spindle has the tapered hole. The test mandrel has the taper. So the test mandrel is inserted into the tapered hole of the spindle. And the dial indicator is stand is fixed on the table. And its feeler is made to touch the surface of the test mandrel. And then the test mandrel is rotated for one complete revolution. At the spindle is rotated slowly and the readings are noted for any variations. And maximum permissible error not exceed 0.03 mm for Morse taper number 2. And for Morse taper more than number 2, maximum error allowed is 0.04 mm. Another test is parallelism of the spindle axis with its vertical movements. So here the test, we require a test mandrel and a dial gauge. So how to conduct the test? This test is conducted in both the planes. So this test is performed in two planes, A and B. So at right angles to each other. So this is this is the horizontal plane and this is the vertical plane. So the test mandrel is fitted into the taper hole of the spindle. And the dial gauge is fixed on the table with its feeler touching the mandrel. So this is the, plane A. This is the plane A. And perpendicular to this, so we'll place the dial indicator like this. So we'll conduct the test. So the spindle is adjusted in the middle position of its travel. The spindle is moved in upper and lower directions of the middle position of its travel. So the spindle is moved upper and lower directions of the middle position with a slow vertical feed mechanism. And the readings of the dial indicator are noted. So here we can observe the position of the dial indicator. So the maximum error for plane A is 0.03 mm and for plane B it is 0.05 mm. squareness of a clamping surface of the table to its axis. So for conducting this test, we require a dial gauge. So how to conduct this test? The dial indicator is mounted on the tapered hole of the spindle, and its feeler is made to touch the table top surface. So the table is then moved slowly and the readings are noted. So if the table is moved, and the maximum permissible error is 0.05 mm for 300 mm diameter of the table. Squareness of the spindle axis with the table. So for conducting this, we require a straight edge and a dial gauge. So this test is performed by placing the straight edge in position, let us AA. So here the straight edge is placed AA position, and straight edge is placed in BB position, BB dash position. So the work table is arranged in the middle of its vertical travel. So the dial gauge is mounted in the tapered hole of the spindle, and its feeler is made to touch the straight edge first at A point. And then we will note down what is the reading of the dial indicator. And then the spindle is rotated through 180 degrees such that the dial indicator will, feeler of the dial indicator contacts at point A dash. Again, we will note down the variation in the reading, that is squareness on the dial indicator. So the difference of these two readings is the error and squareness of the spindle axis with the table. So similar readings are taken by placing the straight edge in BB position, that is perpendicular to the initial position. And the maximum permissible error allowed is only 0.08. with the lower end of the spindle inclined towards the column only for a setup AA, and 0.05 for setup BB. Next, alignment test on a radial drilling machine. So the saddle moment parallel to the base plate. This is the first test. Saddle moment parallel to the base plate. So the instruments required are, one is dial gauge. So a dial gauge is fixed to the spindle with its plunger bearing on the surface of the base plate. So this is the base plate and this is the spindle. And the feeler of the dial gauge is made to touch the surface of the base plate. The saddle is then moved along the arm. So we have the arm. So the saddle is moved. So any deviation from parallelism with the base plate should be on an inclination upward towards the column that should not exceed 0.16 mm per meter. The second test is spindle and feed movement squareness with the base plate. So for conducting this, we require a dial gauge with a suitable attachment for fixing a horizontal rod to the spindle. So how to conduct the test? To check the squareness of the spindle, so a horizontal rod is fixed. This is the horizontal rod which is fixed to the dial gauge. So this is attached to the radius of about 300 mm. And the plunger of the dial gauge is arranged to bear on the base plate and is brought into the two positions. So this is the position A and this is the position B. So by the rotation of the spindle, so here the spindle is rotated. So readings are taken in two positions and check the squareness in the plane of the arm. So, and also we'll take the two readings at right angles to those shown. in order to check the squareness in the plane perpendicular to the arc. And readings should be taken with the spindle in four different positions, namely near to and remote from the column, with the arm first and low, and then high up on the column. And the permissible error is 0.16 mm per meter. So that is. Next, coming to the acceptance test for the surface grinders. The first test is a table top parallel to its movement. So for conducting this, we require a dial gauge. So how to conduct this test? By fitting the dial gauge in the stationary spindle, and the feeler of the dial gauge is touching the table top surface and traversing the table. So here the table is moved. Second test is slots parallel to table movement. So by fitting the dial gauge in the stationary spindle and a dial feeler touching the slot and traversing the table. And third test is a spindle axis parallel to the top side, top surface. So this test is conducted by fitting the dial gauge on the radial arm of the spindle and its feeler touching the square, which is resting on the table, and rotating the spindle by 180 degrees. So at a different location, so we'll take the dial gauge readings, and then the difference will give us the error in the squareness. And the spindle axis square with the slots. So by fitting the dial gauge on the arc fitted to the spindle and the rotating by the spindle by 180 degrees. Vertical movement of the spindle squareness with the tabletop surface. This test is conducted by fitting the dial gauge in spindle and its feeler touching the square resting on the table. And what is a practical test or performance test? So performance test consists of checking the accuracy of the finished components and is known as the practical test. So this test consists of the preparing the actual test jobs on the machine and checking the accuracy of the jobs produced. So this test is carried out to know whether the machine tool is capable of producing the parts within the specified limits or not. So practical test forms the part of acceptance test for the machine tools. So this mainly reveals the alignment accuracy of the machine tools under dynamic loading. So these tests also indicate whether the machine has been installed correctly on its foundation or not, as per the specifications. Practical tests are usually specified by the manufacturers only. So these tests are designed to reveal the combined effects of possible errors in alignment accuracy and the rigidity of the machine. So the test consists of the actual testing of some jobs on the machine. The job is made under a prescribed condition of cutting speed, feeder, and depth of cut. The test piece is then measured for its geometry and surface finish, and the results are compared with the standards as prescribed by the manufacturer. So for example, in the case of central lathe, the national standards as well as the manufacturers specifies the following. So these are the dimensions. So here the cylindrical workpiece we have having the diameter equal to 1/8 of the length of the workpiece, and length from half to full distance between the centers is measured at three diameters, one diameter, second diameter, and the third diameter. It is half to full. So over a maximum length of 20 mm. So the measured portion should be cylindrical, and for acceptance, the error should not exceed 0.02 mm for 300 mm length. So this is about the lecture 3. So in this lecture, we understood how to conduct the alignment test on a pillar type drilling machine. for testing the flatness of the clamping surface of the base, flatness of the clamping surface of the table, perpendicularity of the drill guide to the table base plate, perpendicularity of the spindle sleeve with the base plate, true running of the spindle taper, parallelism of the spindle axis with its vertical moments, squareness of a clamping surface of the table to its axis, squareness of the spindle axis with the table, and alignment test on radial drilling machine, saddle moment parallel to the base plate, and spindle and feed moment squareness with the base plate. And acceptance test for the surface grinders to check the tabletop surface parallel to its movement, and slots parallel to the table movement, spindle axis parallel to the tabletop, spindle axis squareness with the T-slots, and vertical movement of the spindle square with the tabletop, and then practical tests or performance tests. So this is about today's lecture. Thank you.